Karena tabingnya.
Nanti gue pernah tanya.
Mutual fund. Grabe. Yes. Okay. So, mutual fund investment management.
Yes. Oh,
so, kasi for the past episodes, we've been sharing with them yung mga strategies, paano ba pumili ng mutual fund.
Ano yung mga terms? Oh, ayan, nasa playlist natin tas, yan.
Ano yung matching principle, di ba?
Oh, oh.
Ano yung goal mo, dapat match dun yung pipili
mutual
mo
fund. Fund. Oh. Oh, yes.
So, ang assumption ay nakapili na sila ng mutual fund investment, mm-hmm. nakapaglagay na rin sila ng pera, nakapag-open sila ng account.
Andun ka na.
Oh, oh. So, ang tanong ngayon is, what's next? Diba?
What's next?
Oh, sabi natin, kunwari ako, naka... Oh. Meron akong long-term goal,
mm-hmm.
tapos which means dapat pwede akong mag-invest sa isang long-term type of na mm-hmm. instrument like an equity fund, di ba?
Oh, oh,
so, naglagay na ako ng pera sa equity fund, nakapag-invest na ako.
Mm-hmm.
Tapos ano na gagawin ko ngayon? Yun. I'm sure may mga nagtataka sa kanila kasi I've received a few questions na yun din yung tanong. So, sir, what's next? Sabi sa akin.
Okay. First things first kasi, ang beauty ng mutual fund is that you don't really need to trade. Okay? Mm-hmm. O may video din kami dyan about that. Because when you buy into a fund, it's the fund manager who'll be trading on your behalf. So, what stocks?
Sino yung magmamanage?
Oo na.
Kaya nga, mutual fund
kumaga,
manager.
Kumaga, meron kang sariling, ano, sariling driver. Ganyan. Kaya ka nag-provide ng management fee na bawas na rin sa presyo nun. But, then again, oh, as the market, you know, moves, as the economy moves also, whether locally and internationally, kailangan hindi ka lang prente, di ba? Hindi ka lang relax. So, dapat, after you've invested, may mga titingnan ka rin mga bagay-bagay regarding your mutual fund investment. Number one is performance.
Okay, performance.
Performance, okay. Your mutual fund kasi, of course, it would give returns depending sa market and depending sa underlying basket of goods, pero syempre titingnan mo rin yung mutual fund mo, how is it performing? Number one, versus the peers.
Okay.
So for example, bumili ako ng mutual fund invested in the stock market. So, ang gagawin ko is, how does my mutual fund compare or stack up with the competitor?
Ibang funds that invests in the stock market.
The stock market. Kung dapat apples na apples ha. Kasi kunwari, naka-equity mutual fund ka, dapat ikukumpara mo siya sa equity mutual fund also.
Oo, hindi pwedeng equity UITF.
Actually, pwede rin. Or bond fund. Basta dapat equity, bond, para you're comparing apples to apples.
Okay.
Yan, okay. So, for example, nag-invest ako sa, alam naman natin lahat, kunwari, Sun Life, di ba?
Mm.
Nag-invest ako sa Sun Life. Now, check nyo rin kung yung Sun Life, for example, no, at least once a year, and I recommend at least once a year, titignan nyo kung halimbawa, how does the performance of Sun Life compare to Phil Equity?
Uh-huh.
Yan, compare to Philam Asset, uh-huh. compare to First Metro Asset, ano pa ba yung mga mutual fund dyan?
Popular. Oh, basta yan.
AFM, okay? You can go to ano to the website pala of mutual funds, yung worldwideweb.pifa.com.ph. Okay, makikita nyo dyan sa link dyan. And you can compare, no, because a mutual fund's performance, dapat titignan nyo rin. Dapat hindi siya yung baragoong.
Uh-oh.
Okay? Kasi baka mamaya, yung fund na i-invest na natin, hindi na maganda yung management. Of course, you having a fund manager, meron ding human factor.
Yes, yes.
Okay? Most especially for the actively managed funds. Now, may video din kami to. Uh-huh. Dyan. So, for actively managed funds, titignan mo rin, no, baka mamaya hindi magandang investment decisions or hindi nagiging magandang management ng mutual fund, tapos medyo nagdalag siya sa performance, medyo balagoong, then maybe it's time to rethink your portfolio and maybe tingnan nyo rin, baka you can invest from an underperforming mutual fund to an overperforming one.
So, you parang
recommending na... beauty contest.
Bakit beauty contest? Pagandahan. So, would you recommend na pagpangit yung performance, ilalabas mo, tapos ipapasok mo dun sa naging maganda yung performance?
Well, not necessarily, kasi baka mamaya, dikit-dikit lang din. And when you go to pifa.com.ph, okay, you just don't look for the year-to-date performance, meaning from January until that date. You look for the previous 1, 3, and 5 years. So, kung nakikita niyo na yung performance ng fund, eh medyo parang 1, 3, and 5 years and year-to-date, super nasa bottom half siya, or bottom 25%, man, medyo you have to rethink na baka it's being not managed well. So, it might be better to go for the top half or the top quartile ng
mutual fund. Not necessarily the number one. Basta not necessarily the nasa top half. Ako, I think, ang magandang strategy dyan is if yung mutual fund mo is not performing as well as the other funds, then syempre yung mga investment mo, dinadagdagan mo naman, di ba?
Yes.
So maybe it's time for you to invest in sa mga dinanyuan. Especially if it's a long-term investment. Then, kasi talo ka rin sa mga fees kung sell and then invest ulit, di ba?
And remember, sa mutual funds, may tinatawag tayo na entry fee na pagka-invest mo, halimbawa, sinabi nilang 5% entry fee, 5% investment mo, oops, is ibabawas nila.
Yeah. So, yun nga. So, for example, if I am investing, sabihin na natin na
mutual fund X.
5,000 pesos a month, no? So after a year, tinignan ko yung performance ng mutual fund ko. It's in the bottom half of the list of funds. Then probably it's
across all year. Across all investment horizon na 1, 3, 5 years ganyan.
So probably sa next year I'll invest in a new fund na lang. Tapos yung existing fund ko, since it's a long-term investment, pwede ko sigurong bigyan muna sila ng...
Bigyan mo ng chance.
Ng chance na bumawi for the
one
next year.
One more chance.
So, especially for long-term, siguro pag mga 3 years...
Actually, okay na yung 3 years. Yeah.
Underperformance, okay, pwede ko na sigurong kunin yun, tapos ilagay
fair enough na yun. Fair enough. Kung naman 3 years, ano ginagawa mo, underperform ka pa rin.
So, kung mga 1 year pa lang, 2 years...
Okay lang yun.
Pwede mo siyang munang bigyan ng chance na bumawi, pero in terms of sa mga bagong mong i-invest, baka mas maganda sa iba na lang muna.
Para medyo mahilaw yung performance. So that is versus peers. Pangalawa, you also compare your mutual fund not just versus peers, but versus the benchmark.
The index.
The benchmark, which is usually the index. Because all mutual funds, they have their own benchmark. Yung benchmark is yung tipong yung performance na gusto nilang
Mahit or talunin,
which is usually the index. So for example, yung mutual fund mo has been consistently outperforming the index.
Then that's a good sign.
It's a good sign, but if it's consistently underperforming with the various time horizons, underperforming the index, then maybe, you know,
again,
time to review again. Kasi ganito, pwede rin kasi na, okay, medyo complicated na to, but a bit more complicated. Pwede kasi na your fund could be beating, your fund could be underperforming the benchmark, or it could underperform the index, pero pag versus peers mo, lahat ng peers underperforming the lahat ng peers, kasi pwede mangyari yun, pwedeng lahat ng mutual fund versus the equity tracker or the equity index funds, no, pwedeng nangyari yun na yung mga actively managed mutual funds, pwede na karamihan sa kanila would be underperforming the index. So kumbaga, if they're all underperforming the index, then okay lang yun. Kasi lahat naman below eh. Diba?
Yes,
below the
yes.
index. So, pero pag versus peers, medyo angat ka pa rin, okay lang yun. Pero papangit naman na underperform ka na versus index, tas versus the peers, nasa
mababa ka pa,
then it's not quite a good sign.
So sa akin,
pero nakakatakot din ha, kung lahat ng fund is underperforming na index, tapos yung fund ngayon, is ano, overperforming.
They, ah, dapat hindi rin siya ano.
Oo, kasi baka mamaya naman is lahat ng
ginagawang activity magic.
Oo, yun. Parang what are they smoking, di ba?
Pero yun nga, unang-una, if all the actively managed funds are underperforming the index, mm-hmm. then...
Forgivable.
Forgivable, but for me, if I have new money to invest, I would probably put it in an index fund.
Mm-hmm.
Di ba? Mm-hmm. So, again, you monitor yung performance in the past. Mm-hmm. Ngayon, kung hindi maganda yung performance ng currently na nilalagyan mo na mutual fund, then yung mga bago mong i-invest, you can put it in a new fund.
Mm-hmm.
And in cases na yung lahat ng mga actively managed funds mm-hmm. Underperforming the index, mm-hmm. then probably it's a good idea na for this year, sa index fund ko na lang nilalagay.
And there's a year, ha? I think there are like at least one or two years na ang mga top mutual funds are index
funds. Index funds, yes.
No actively managed mutual fund has outperformed index. Oh. Nangyayari yun. So yeah, it could be a blended ano, yeah. A blended approach.
And yun nga, sabi mo, you also have to see, no, baka mamaya, yung isang mutual fund, eh, siya lang yung nag-iisang sobrang taas.
Nako, medyo.
Tas, yung peers niya, eh, kuwari, yung isang mutual fund.
Positive, kunwari, positive 20, tapos lahat, mga negative 5, negative 2, oh. Parang medyo tingnan mo rin kasi kung super underlying, masyado. Baka pag bumagsak yung market, ando dun din siya sa super dulo.
Saka
which
na,
happens.
Tsaka suspicious yun, baka.
O, anong laman?
O, kung anong ginagawa, oh, diba? Anong fund manager.
Yeah.
Kasi, of course, all these funds, especially yung mga peso denominated funds, they're all investing in the local economy,
mm-hmm.
local stock market, local bonds, mm-hmm. alam mo yun. Mm-hmm. So, you could expect na hindi ganun kalaki or kalayo yung mga differences in performance nila.
Yes, yes.
So, kung merong isang parang runaway na sobrang...
parang tawag, runaway bride.
Hindi, may tawag dun eh.
Outlier.
Outlier.
Oh, outlier.
There's an outlier.
Yeah.
We're not saying na automatically ay masama yun. But,
but
if there's an outlier, it's important for you
maigi.
To investigate oh, bakit siya gano'n. And kung merong talagang outlier na fund, I'm very sure may business article na nasulat yan.
Mm-hmm.
Di ba? Kasi all the financial analysts in the country will be monitoring this. And if there's a fund that has significantly outperformed others, this analyst will surely write about them.
Right.
So it's your ano ngayon, responsibility to keep updated. Ano ba yung nangyari? Bakit sobrang laki nito? Mm-hmm. Di ba? So,
and you can see that, you can see yung laman ng mutual fund in their fund performance report or yung fact sheet
uh-oh.
Na you can download from the website.
Yes.
Another thing, okay, in this is a tip for you as well. For those invested in balanced funds,
mm-hmm.
di ba yung may stock, may equities na, may bonds pa,
yes.
tingnan ninyo yung portfolio composition. Mm-hmm. Typically, a balanced fund would be 50-50.
Uh-oh.
But some funds kasi are swinger funds. Minsan magmo-more than 50.
Yan yung mga dynamic allocation.
Pero yung iba kasi balance fund pero dynamic pa rin. Not necessarily name. Now, ang tip ko dyan is, pag nakikita ninyo na medyo nagtitilt dumadami yung portfolio composition on the stocks,
mm-hmm.
ibig sabihin nun, bullish sila sa economy.
Okay.
Kasi bullish
so
sa stock market.
They think na aakit pa yung stock
oo,
market.
Oo, kasi kumbaga, minsan some balance funds do 70%. Ha?
So, pwede mo, again, you check it against their peers. Tingnan mo yung mga balance, ibang balance fund, no?
Mm-hmm.
Umaakit din ba yung stock allocation
yes.
ng mga ibang balance fund?
Tama.
Kung yung mga ibang mga balance fund ay hindi umaakit ang allocation sa stock market, then...
Tingnan mo, baka may nakikita silang hindi nakikita ng iba, or baka hindi na ma-manage. Well,
so, I guess the main point here is, hindi ka mag-i-invest tapos hayaan mo na siya.
No.
Okay. So, it's still your responsibility to monitor ano yung performance ng fund na pinili mo.
Mm-hmm.
And then, especially if you have more money that you want to invest.
Yes.
Instead of just parang, dito na lang kasi dito na ako eh.
Oh.
Minsan, it's more prudent to probably invest in a new one if yung current one na pinili mo ay underperforming.
Yes.
And of course, wag maging, anong tawag dito, yung madaling makonvince na pangit na to, ilipat ko na agad. So give it, especially if it's a long-term investment.
Mga 3 years.
Mga 3 years before nyo, before kayo mag-decide na ilipat ko na lang, di ba?
Yes.
Kasi minsan talaga, there are bad years. So, pero kung 3 consistent na bad years, pangit na yun, lipat nyo na. No?
Lipat yun na. May mga ganong funds.
And of course, pagdating sa mga low-risk funds, like mga fixed income, money market,
yeah.
I think, kung nag-underperform, as in, siguro nasa really bottom half, mas safe na na ilipat. Kasi no, short term yun eh. Alang-alang mag-intake pa lang 3 years. So, depende. So, kung short term or low risk fund yan, tapos nag-underperform siya na after a year, pwede siyang ilipat na sa isa, sa ibang mas maganda. Kung balance fund naman yan, yeah, siguro give it like 3 years.
3 years also.
Pag mga equity,
mga
3 years.
Another thing pa na titingnan ninyo is check if yung return ng fund is yung pari yung nabibigay na return sa inyo, na balak nyo.
Yung
plano nyo. Kumbaga, lumalapit ba kayo? Siyempre, nag-i-invest ako for a goal, di ba? Ang kondo, ng pang-college, ng mga anak ko, or pang ano ba, pang retirement ko. So halimbawa, balak ko is 1.2 million for my children's education funding. So i-check nyo rin, no, na lumalaki ba yung investment ninyo in that fund, kung lumalapit ba dun sa target amount ninyo, na 1.2 million. Kasi kung hindi, then hindi mo mahihit ang goal mo.
Tama.
Diba? And the reason why these are called investment vehicles, because they should be able to get you to where you want to be.
Yes, yes.
Diba? So kung mabagal, okay, then delete at hindi mo mahihit yung target amount mo, then it makes sense, you know, to go out of the vehicle and shift to another vehicle.
Yes, yes.
Oh, so titingnan niyo rin yung kung lumalapit kayo.
So basically, kumare nag-invest ka, tapos ang goal mo ay magkaroon ng 2 million after 9 years,
yes.
Diba?
O 5 years na, 500,000 ka pa din, halimbawa.
Oo, so medyo, dapat kasi after 5
years. 4 years na lang.
Dapat after 5 years,
medyo dapat 1
million na yun.
More or less, nangangalahati ka na.
More or less, kasi 9 years yung goal mo, diba? So after 5 years, dapat more than half, more than 1.5. More than 1 million na yung value. So kung hindi pa, then probably it's best to shift to another fund. No?
Kasi another fund na mas maganda yung return. Kasi maghahabol ka na eh. Kaya dapat every year talaga nire-review. Kasi mahirap na, malapit na yung goal mo, 1-2 years na lang. Eh kung halimbawa, yun nga, 9 years tapos 2 million. Eh ire-review mo 7th year pa lang, tapos 500,000. Eh talaga makukumabog ka na. No?
Yes.
Super risky na ng investment na
para or sa mas malaki yung kailangan mong idagdag na
idagdag. Oo. So yun.
Anyway, I hope may natutunan kayo. Medyo complicated, no?
So medyo may konting ano tayo.
And that's extra, actually extra. One of the, again, services that we offer as a
professional financial planner.
Yes.
We're professionals. Kahit naka-t-shirt na kami ng House of Obagi.
Meron kaming investment audit.
Yes. So,
and of course, we can also advise you kung ano yung mga magagandang steps or investments or ano yung mga magagandang strategies that can help you reach your financial goals.
Kasi so, sa market pa lang, mga 200 plus ng investments eh.
Yes.
So
kung medyo busy kayo with other things to analyze work and business, diba? Kung wala kayo masyadong time para mag-analyze sa market and you want someone to help you, yeah. So, nandito kami. So, you just send us an email.
Happy to serve. Kaya ba yun?
Hindi ko alam eh. Yan. So, sa Pure Gold kasi ako namin. Hindi sa SM.
Sorry, we stand sa
ako. Ayan. Wow, kasi yayamanin ka. Alright. Sige. So, send us an email sa admin@webarchy.com. And then, if you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up and share it to your friends. And please don't forget